What's up, fam? It's your boy B Hound the Check-In. And hey, man, you know right now with the Black Lives Matter movement going crazy in the streets as we speak, you know, Lakers center Dwight Howard, one of the more than 80 NBA players on the conference call on Friday, they discussed the league's return to play. He agrees with Nets guard Kyrie Irving's hesitation about the league returning this summer, citing the desire not to distract from the current Black Lives Matter movement. You know, Howard, through his agent, told CNN's Jill Martin that basketball or entertainment, period, isn't needed at this moment and will only be a distraction. I would love nothing more than to win my very first NBA championship, but the unity of my people would be an even bigger championship. And that's just too beautiful to pass up. What better time than now for us to be focusing on our families? No basketball till we get things resolved. NBA spokesperson Mike Bass said, "We understand the players' concerns and are working with the Players Association on finding the right balance to address them." Clippers guard Lou Williams said publicly in a statement on Saturday that resuming the season would be a distraction that could potentially keep societal change from continuing to happen. However, Rockets guard Austin Rivers put out a lengthy statement on Instagram stating that he believes players could use the money and platform they'd get from playing out the season to further the Black Lives Matter movement. He was quoted as saying, "Us coming back will put money in all of our pockets. With this money, you could help out even more people and continue to give, more importantly, your time and energy towards the BLM movement, which I'm 100% on board with, because change needs to happen and injustice has been going on too long." The league is reportedly not requiring its players to participate in the season restart if they are uncomfortable in doing so. Players who voluntarily sit out would lose a portion of their salaries, but would otherwise face no consequences. And on the other hand, you know, some players are disagreeing with Kyrie Irving, you know, arguing that 4 months of daily media coverage fed to millions of sports star fans can be an even stronger vehicle for their message. You know, basketball's strongest voice and most recognizable face, LeBron James, is reportedly leading the fight in favor of finishing the season. Earlier last week, you know, James announced the formation of a voting rights group along with Hawks guard Trae Young in hopes of increasing Black voter turnout and ending Black voter suppression. James reportedly was not on the call on Friday, and it has been reported that LeBron James wants to continue to play while also being a voice for social change. LeBron was quoted as saying, "Because of everything that's going on, people are starting to finally listen to us. We feel like we're finally getting a foot in the door. How long is it up to us? We don't know. But we feel like we're getting some ears and some attention, and this is the time for us to finally make a difference." Though Kyrie, who underwent a season-ending shoulder injury, already wasn't planning on playing in the 22-team bubble game approved last week by the NBA Board of Governors and Players Union, the Nets guard would sacrifice millions of dollars if play did not resume. Players who have already seen their paychecks reduced by the shortening of the regular season and make significantly less than Kyrie's $33 million salary next season could see the NBA's economic structure collapse if play does not restart in the summer. Without a conclusion to a 2019-20 season, the NBA could terminate the collective bargaining agreement by exercising the force majeure provision due to the COVID-19 pandemic, trigger a lockout, then slash player salaries. And then, with uncertainty surrounding whether fans will be able to attend games in the 2021 season, that would be giving the union little leverage. And that's just where it is right now. You know, this coronavirus, you know, has also caused a lot of people, including the working class, to lose their jobs. So, I mean, they're not getting any money anyway. So a lot of people are not really feeling too sorry for NBA players that are making millions of dollars a year, you know, having their salaries cut. And I'm going to just be real about that. Nobody really cares about that, because how can you feel sorry for somebody that's making millions of dollars a year? Now, I definitely understand that they got families to feed and people to take care of. And that's real right there. But in the grand scheme of things, when it comes to social justice and, you know, the ability to be able to walk these streets as a full citizen of the United States of America and not have to worry about being murdered by police or just having to deal with oppression in general, I think that, you know, it would be best to side with the BLM movement right about now in order to move the culture forward. I mean, that's really what we need right now. We need to change. We need to change now, because now is the time. If we don't handle the business now, hey, guess what? It might be another 400 years of looking crazy around here. And I don't want my kids or my kids to have to go through the things that I've gone through, or my parents or great grandparents and, you know, ancestors went through as well, you know. So right now is the time to make a change. Right now is the time to move the country forward in a better way, to make it even an equal and opportunity for all to just live a life of liberty. love, and peace. And I'm going to just sit there right there, you know. Salute to Dwight Howard. Salute to Kyrie Irving. Salute to all of the athletes that are standing with the people and really supporting the movement. Because if you have seen any of the videos, man, this is heartbreaking to have to ingest. You know, we're thinking about these folks' families that have passed. They have to, you know, deal with this kind of stuff as well, man. And I mean, it's not, you know, it happens so much that we become desensitized to everything. And it just turns into like another killing, another murder, like this is some kind of video game. But no, this is real life. These are real people. These are real families. These are real kids and children that are being affected by this stuff. And hey, man, we need justice. We need peace and we need resolution in this thing. Okay. So once again, anybody that's willing to fight a good fight and stand up for the people and move the culture forward. I mean, it's only, you know, a piece of a season that you'll be losing out on. You know, basketball will be right back to normal and they're going to get right back to paying folks after all of this stuff is, you know, resolved. But let's go ahead and get some kind of resolution first before we go back out here and start distracting everybody from what's really going on. And I'm going to just sit there right there. Beehive Radio, shout it, man. Hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, follow your folk, and get down with the movement. More content on the way, more interviews on the way, man. I'm gone. Holla.